Darkness at the break of noon, shadows, even the silver spoon, the handmade
blade. Hi, I'm Robert Melamede, PhD. I'm an associate professor at the University of Colorado at Colorado Springs in the biology department. And I'm a very strong advocate for the use of medical marijuana for a whole lot of reasons. But all of them, in fact, other than my own personal experiences, are truly science-based. So that today we live in a world where we have a tremendous amount of knowledge about not only the body in general and how it works, but how the marijuana-like compounds, endocannabinoids that we all produce, wind up regulating literally everything in our body. So all of our body systems, our digestive system, respiratory system, immune system, reproductive system, nervous system, and anything I forgot, all of those are involved in a balancing act between what essentially amounts to pro-inflammatory biochemistry and anti-inflammatory biochemistry.
Well, you need immediate pain relief, and that is best provided unambiguously by narcotics, by opiate-based narcotics. However, when you have healed and you are no longer suffering acute pain and you have chronic long-term pain, those narcotics are no longer the answer. First of all, they make you constipated and they make you depressed. So what we're seeing in our soldiers that are coming back from these long tours of duty is chronic pain, depression, and suicides. Now, let's put one and one together and see what's going on here. Well, they have chronic pain because they've been injured. They're given narcotics, which make them depressed. They're giving antidepressants, which have the consequence of promoting suicide. Well, let's look further at cannabis-based medicines here. All right? They are antidepressant in their behavior. You know, the whole concept of getting high, euphoria, right? Well, that's what these soldiers need. They're depressed. They need an antidepressant. The natural antidepressant is your endocannabinoid system, and the natural way to supplement that is with cannabis. So these are the medicines that we're going to target first, because we know that there's such a tremendous need for them. We know that they work because our veterans tell us that they work. And we feel that it's our obligation to provide this medicine for our soldiers who have done so much for our country and are now being basically screwed by our government and by our military system.
What essentially amounts to pro-inflammatory biochemistry and anti-inflammatory biochemistry. And those are held in check as they go back and forth. You have an inflammation because you have an infection. You got to pull that back so that you're no longer in that inflamed state. And that's what one of the many things that your endocannabinoid system participates in turning down these inflammatory responses. And there's tremendous amount of significance to that, because 100 years ago, when we lived in a much dirtier environment with less options with respect to certain kinds of medicines, like antibiotics, because they were not available, under those conditions, people were dying at a younger age, and they were dying predominantly from from infectious diseases. Today, what we're dying from are age-related diseases, of which free radicals are believed to be one of the fundamental etiological components. In other words, free radicals are thought to be responsible for aging. So that it turns out that inflammation and free radicals kind of go hand in hand. They're part of the same biochemistry. And the way our bodies turn down that response is by the use of endocannabinoids, these marijuana-like compounds that we produce from essential fatty acids. We all hear how essential fatty acids are important for your health and for protecting your heart. What's not mentioned is that they are converted into endocannabinoids, and we know that endocannabinoids protect your heart and have all sorts of other health benefits. So, you know, we just need such a higher new degree of education, and it's not happening sufficiently, certainly in our schools. I probably teach one of the only courses on endocannabinoids and medical marijuana in the country, and yet we're dealing with something that's so fundamental to all of our lives, to how we work, and to conditions where we have imbalances, we all suffer a common imbalance. We're all getting older. So these age-related illnesses come as a result of the accumulation of these inflammatory conditions, so to speak, until the weakest link in our individual chain breaks, and that becomes an illness that we have to then deal with. And here you have this plant that can be grown very effectively and inexpensively, that has components, some of which are of profound medical value, that don't even get you high, but they're still illegal because of some totally undivine wisdom here. So we have to make some significant changes. We have to be able to use these plant materials in combination, because it's the whole milieu that has an impact. What you want to do with changing towards health is impact not just one little place, but you want to impact the whole system and move the whole body towards health. And the way these cannabinoids work on so many different levels within your biochemistry, within your organized systems, it's how they culminate to help move an individual towards health. You know, the fact that they're involved in your sleeping, your eating, your appetite, you know, your reproductive behavior, everything that's positive is tuned with these things. And it's just insane what's going on, that this is not readily available, that people get arrested for it, people get put in jail, and we have to pay for the special privilege of getting permits so that we can get our medicine. This is just, something's fundamentally wrong. Time for a change. To hear that somebody thinks they really found you.